The second branch of the trigeminal nerve is the maxillary nerve. It contains somatic sensory, taste, and autonomic nerve fibers. As it emerges from the trigeminal ganglion, the maxillary nerve passes through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Prior to exiting the cranium, the first direct branch occurs. This is the middle meningeal branch, responsible for the sensory innervation of the meninges of the middle cranial fossa. Distal to this branch, the nerve leaves the cranium through foramen rotundum and enters the pterygopalatine fossa. From the main trunk, two direct branches separate, reaching the pterygopalatine ganglion. The ganglion is a group of neuron cell bodies in the peripheral nervous system. Although it is described as parasympathetic, the pterygopalatine ganglion also contains sympathetic and sensory fibers. Preganglionic, parasympathetic secretomotor fibers from the intermediate nerve, which is branch of the facial nerve, form the greater petrosal nerve. Postganglionic, sympathetic vasomotor fibers from the internal carotid plexus form the lesser petrosal nerve. Together, these two nerves form the nerve of the pterygoid canal, which carries parasympathetic and sympathetic fibers to the pterygopalatine ganglion. The ganglion receives its somatic sensory fibers from the maxillary nerve, so each branch which originates from the pterygopalatine ganglion carries parasympathetic, sympathetic and somatic sensory fibers. If you find this video valuable, hit the like button, subscribe and comment. You can join our mission by contributing on Patreon. First and second branch of the pterygopalatine ganglion are the medial posterior superior and the lateral posterior superior nasal branches. They enter the nasal cavity through the sphenopalatine foramen and supply the nasal mucosa. The middle nasal branch innervates the nasal roof and the septum. Terminal branch of the nerve is the nasopalatine nerve. It travels downward and forward on the nasal septum, reaching the anterior floor of the nasal cavity. Then it enters the incisive canal and appears on the hard palate through the incisive foramen. It innervates the gingiva of the hard palate from canine to canine. The lateral nasal branch innervates the lateral wall of the nasal cavity and the inferior nasal conha. Third and fourth branches of the pterygopalatine ganglion are the greater and lesser palatine nerves, which travel inferiorly through the palatine bone and maxilla. The greater palatine nerve appears on the hard palate through the greater palatine foramen. It innervates the hard palate unilaterally from canine to wisdom tooth, the lateral posterior nasal wall and the maxillary sinus mucosa. The lesser palatine innervates the palatine tonsils and the soft palate, and it carries additional taste fibers to the soft palate. Fifth and sixth branch of the pterygopalatine ganglion are the pharyngeal branch, which supplies the mucosa of the nasopharynx, and the orbital branch, which innervates the ethmoidal air cells. The third direct branch of the maxillary nerve is the zygomatic nerve. It arises in the pterygopalatine fossa and enters the orbit through the inferior orbital fissure. There, it divides into two terminal branches, the zygomaticotemporal and the zygomaticofacial nerve. The zygomaticotemporal nerve exits the orbit through the zygomaticotemporal foramen and appears in the temporal fossa. The nerve provides sensory innervation to a small area of the skin of the temple superior to the zygomatic arch. The zygomaticofacial nerve exits the orbit laterally and emerges on the face through the zygomaticofacial foramen. It innervates the skin of the prominence of the cheek. Fourth direct branch of the maxillary nerve is the posterior superior alveolar. The nerve leaves the pterygopalatine fossa, going downward and forward, either within or on the posterior wall of the maxilla. It descends on the tuberosity and gives off branches to the bone, vestibular gingiva and the cheek. As the nerve enters the bone through the alveolar canals, it creates the posterior part of the superior dental plexus, which provides sensation to the pulp, periodontium, bone and gingiva of the molar teeth. It communicates with the middle superior alveolar nerve, if present, and gives off branches to the membrane of the maxillary sinus. The fifth direct branch of the maxillary nerve continues forward and laterally as the infraorbital nerve, entering the orbit through the inferior orbital fissure. It lays on the floor of the orbit at first, in the infraorbital groove and then in the infraorbital canal. In the infraorbital groove, the middle superior alveolar nerve branches off. This nerve forms the middle portion of the superior dental plexus, supplying sensory innervation to the pulp, periodontium, bone and gingiva of the premolar teeth and the mesial buccal root of the first molar. Within the infraorbital canal, the infraorbital nerve gives off another branch, the anterior superior alveolar nerve. It enters the bone and reaches the maxillary incisors and canine teeth. It creates the anterior portion of the superior dental plexus. Then, the infraorbital nerve exits the infraorbital canal through the infraorbital foramen and emerges on the face. There, it divides into palpebral branches, nasal branches, and superior labial branches. The palpebral branches innervate the skin of the lower eyelid. The nasal branches supply the skin of the wing of the nose. The superior labial branches descend to supply the skin of the upper lip and the anterior cheek. This video provides a concise summary of the knowledge on this topic derived from the referred sources transformed through my clinical experience. If you find it valuable, hit the like button, subscribe, and drop your questions in the comments below. You can join our mission by contributing on Patreon. Only together we can revolutionize dental education.